talk. Let's have conversations in the dark. World is sleeping, I'm awake with you. With you. Watch movies that we both already seen. I ain't even looking at the screen, it's true. I've got my eyes on you. And you say that you're not worthy. You get hung up on your flaws. But in my eyes, you are perfect as you are. I will never try to change you, change you. I will always want the same you, same you. Swear on everything I pray to that I won't break your heart. I'll be there when you get lonely, lonely. Keep the secrets that you told me, told me. And your love is all you owe me. And I won't break your heart. Sunday mornings we sleep until noon. Well, I could sleep forever next to you. Next to you. And we got places we both gotta be. But there ain't nothing I would rather do than blow up all my plans for you. And you say that you're not worthy and get hung up on your flaws. But in my eyes, you are perfect as you are, as you are. I will never try to change you, change you. I will always want the same you, same you. Swear on everything I pray to that I. My darling, you should know this. My love is everywhere you are. I will never try to change you, change you. I will always want the same you, same you. Swear on everything I pray to.
Cheers, you guys. I'm so excited for you. I seriously can't
believe. We love you so much.
The addition to this family, honestly, that you're bringing is going to be insane.
It is crazy to gain another brother. That's
I'm getting
fun,
a brother.
Caring,
I don't even have any brothers.
That's crazy. Someone that can make inappropriate comments that make me look like I'm fantastic. Come on, let's be real.
Well, let's be real. And on the other hand, you guys get each other.
So much fun, and you're so loving, and your family is the best thing that ever happened to us. It's like
cheers
meant to
be. Many years, man. You're going to be on the
Jonathan. I can't wait
like,
for the life we're about to live.
Over and over. Too many of us. Cheers.
Cheers.
Crazy living, life gets hard to do, and I will.
with my hands. Oh, oh. And back and forth we sway like branches in a storm. Change of weather, still together when it ends. That may be all I need. Darkness, she is all I see. I'll crawl and rest your bones with me. Driving snow on Sunday morning, and I never want to leave. Yeah.
Welcome to all, and thank you for making the journey to take part in this special ceremony. A heartfelt thank you to the friends and family in attendance, especially those who traveled from afar to be with us today. This celebration is made all the more meaningful by your presence. We also remember the members of the Lujinski and Firth families who are celebrating this beautiful day from above. Before we begin, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Jenna Morrell, and I am one of Jonathan's sisters. I'm so honored that Jonathan and Kathleen have asked me to preside over their wedding today. Today is a day to celebrate the love and devotion that unites not only Jonathan and Kathleen, but their families as well. Jonathan and Kathleen, we gather here today to rejoice in the strong bond you share and to honor your genuine commitment to each other's happiness. Two individuals coming together, two halves of the same whole, evenly matched, and in that bond you share many elements. Amongst them, open and honest communication, compassion, patience, love, and affection. What brings us here tonight is truly love. Love is an elusive concept, an emotion, hard to adequately describe, yet we know it when we feel it. Life is full of defining moments. Relationships are full of defining moments, and love is full of defining moments. Jonathan and Kathleen experienced many defining moments as they fell in love with each other, and they will continue to experience defining moments throughout their marriage. A defining moment for Kathleen came early on in Jonathan and Kathleen's relationship. Kathleen and her pup-up were always very close. At the time, he wasn't doing well, and she realized he wouldn't see her get married or start a family of her own. Kathleen always hoped her pup-up would at least get to meet her future husband. Shortly after Kathleen's pup-up passed away, she met Jonathan. Kathleen truly believes that Jonathan is a blessing in her life sent to her from her pup-up. A defining moment for Jonathan was when he knew he found someone he loves and respects. In Kathleen, Jonathan found someone he wants to spend the rest of his life with. He found someone he wants to start a family with. A defining moment for Jonathan was when he knew he found someone he will love and honor for all the days of his life. A series of defining moments in Jonathan and Kathleen's relationship is what brings us here today. In each other, Jonathan and Kathleen have found the person with whom they want to spend the rest of their lives with. When you realize you want to spend the rest of your life with someone, that is life's most significant defining moment. Our bride and groom are going to share their vows with one another and all of us as their witnesses. You're going to go first. Repeat after me, okay? Hi, Jonathan.
Hi, Jonathan.
Take you, Kathleen.
Take you, Kathleen.
As my wife and my companion.
My wife and my companion.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
To honor you.
To honor you.
And to share my life with you.
And to share my life with you.
I offer you my hand.
I offer you my hand.
My heart.
My heart.
And my love.
And my love.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
Kathleen, now it's your turn. I, Kathleen.
I, Kathleen.
Take you, Jonathan.
Take you, Jonathan.
As my husband and my companion.
As my husband and my companion.
I promise to love you.
Promise to love you.
To honor you.
To honor you.
And to share my life with you.
To share my life with you.
I offer you my hand.
I offer you my hand.
My heart.
My heart.
And my love from this day forward.
And my love from this day forward.
Jonathan and Kathleen, please join hands. Jonathan, do you declare your deepest desire to spend your days and years together? Do you promise your love, your friendship, your strength, and your fidelity to Kathleen? Do you intend to stand by her side as her devoted husband today and for all of your tomorrows? If so, please say, I do. Kathleen, do you declare your... Do you declare your deepest desire to spend your days and years together? Do you promise your love, your friendship, your strength, and your fidelity to Jonathan? Do you intend to stand by his side as his devoted wife today and for all of your tomorrows? If so, please say, I do.
I do.
With your vows complete, it is time to exchange rings. Forming an unbroken circle, these rings symbolize the lifelong commitment you now enter into. Let them serve as a reminder of the love that you share and the promises you've made before us today. You're going to give Kathleen her ring first, and you're going to repeat after me, okay? Mm-hmm. Yep. I, Jonathan.
I, Jonathan.
Give you, Kathleen.
Give you, Kathleen.
This ring.
This ring.
As a symbol of my love and dedication.
Oh, I put on now.
Yep.
As a symbol of your love and dedication.
Yep. Okay.
Man, you're blinging on that hand.
Now it's your turn.
That was so shaky.
Okay, so you're going to repeat after me when you put it on. Okay. I, Kathleen.
I, Kathleen.
Give you, Jonathan.
Give you, Jonathan.
This ring.
This ring.
As a symbol of my love and dedication.
Symbol of my love and dedication.
Having shared solemn vows and exchanged rings as a symbol of your devotion to one another in the presence of your dearest family and friends, in accordance with the powers vested in me by the Universal Life Church and the state of Florida, it is my honor and privilege to announce that your marriage is now formally sealed and you are now husband and wife. Congratulations to you both. Hi. I invite you to seal your vows with a kiss. Jonathan, you may kiss the bride. Okay, hold on. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to present to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Firth.
Show me just Jessica, Emma, and Jeff.
Together for our prize.
he escorted his mother to the center of the dance floor.
There is nothing for me but to love. With each word, your tenderness grows, tearing my fear apart. And that laugh wrinkles your nose, touches my foolish heart. Lovely, never, never change. Keep that breathless charm. Won't you please arrange it? 'Cause I love you just the way you look tonight. Touches my foolish heart. Lovely, don't you ever change. Keep that breathless charm. Won't you please arrange it? 'Cause I love you just the way you look tonight. Just the way you look tonight.
I need to, you know, down. Good evening, everybody. Thank you so much for coming. We are blessed beyond measure with the amount of people that came here today from all over. And we are so excited to be celebrating you too, lovers. For those of you that don't know me, I'm Kathleen. I'm Kathleen's older sister. They didn't want me to do the speech. They thought I'd be too drunk. Anyway, from the day Kathleen was born, she was my baby doll. And if you've seen any of my home videos, you can always find me holding her, taking care of her, pretending she was my little doll. And as she grew up and matured, I realized that she was just as motherly as me, and her calling in life was going to be a mom. And whatever else professional thing she wanted to do, but she's very nurturing. So, all she needed was to find the perfect match. And then in 2017, she met Jonathan. To find somebody to love her and to get to do her life with a partner. And I am happy to say, and I don't even have to fake it, that you are definitely her perfect match. So, Jonathan is loyal, devoted, hardworking, and loving. And these traits were instilled in Jonathan by his loving parents, Kathy and Rick. Jonathan had the perfect role model for what it means to be a husband in his father, Rick. I know this because the perfect family for me. Rick was so proud of the man Jonathan is and the devotion and love that he showed to Kathleen as he witnessed their relationship begin and grow. We know how truly proud Rick would be of you and as you're united in marriage today. We know he's smiling down today with pride and raising a glass of Tommy Bahama to toast the two of you. begin. So I just want to raise a glass to this amazing couple and end with a little quote and best advice I've heard. It's from the Bible, I think. It's Romans 12:10. Be devoted to one another in love. Honor one another above yourselves. So here's to love, laughter, and happy ever after.
Second toast about the best man, Kevin.
Hello. How's everyone today?
Kevin!
I am Jonathan's cousin, Kevin. For Jonathan's friends, I'm Cuz Kev.
Cousin!
For Kathleen's family, yes, I'm the one who lives in Philadelphia. I think I answered that question 20 times. Cuz John. Congrats, man! What an exciting day for you! You're all grown up and married, this is amazing! I remember you as a little kid with your mom dressing you up in matching purple shirts and socks combos. I used to make fun of you relentlessly about it.
That was a week ago!
I think it was because John loved Barney the Dinosaur. He was just this Dennis the Menace looking kid running around singing Barney songs. But I actually blame Jeffrey for that. Jeffrey, he's over there. So. For a bit in life, we were kind of doing our own thing, and then I moved back to Philadelphia probably 7 years ago, and it was like finding a long-lost brother. We started to hang out all the time, country concerts, dinners, beer festivals, ramen. Yeah, I guess ramen. Football games and trips to Aruba, Atlanta, Nashville, and of course NOLA. Gotta get that in. And it's not because of our cousins that we spend time together, it's because you're absolutely my favorite person in the world. I just like love being around you. We can turn anything into a great time. Like causing a scene at Nashville Airport. The time that Jonathan didn't know that ginger beer from Moscow Mules was supposed to be non-alcoholic, so he bought a 6.5% alcohol.
Oh, John!
Dipping out on everyone in New Orleans to watch the Eagles game. The Eagles parade, where you threw the slowest punch I've ever seen in my life. I don't know how you managed to survive being a hockey player your entire life. Maybe a little slower. No matter what we're doing, I always have the best time when you come, so I love you. Kathleen. Little Kath, as I call her. But I guess as of today, it's Cuz Kath. Welcome to the fam, Cuz Kath. From the moment you walk upstairs on Christmas morning and gave your grandmother a heart attack.
Woo!
something different. I should keep an eye on this. Judas had so much confidence walking up the stairs. You were like, I'm here, bitches. I'm here to stay. So you better get used to it.
Swag.
Swag, girl.
Shortly after that, Kathleen and Jonathan started coming to Philadelphia to see me pretty much on a weekly basis. It got to the point where they had their own room, a bathroom in my house, and they were leaving toiletries behind. I was like, I didn't know I was in another relationship. There was all this stuff downstairs. Crazy. And we had some good times. Drinks on the roof, dinners, Tacanelli pizza. And then I noticed my cousin was like holding doors and buying dinners and just like being like, this dude that's like classy. I was like, who is this guy?
James Clancy!
Yeah!
The
new Jay Clancy must be the one!
Love that guy. Oh, never met him.
Little did I know that this love would lead down a long road resulting me missing football Sunday to be in Tampa, Florida for a wedding. But that's okay.
24-8.
But that's okay. I feel privileged to be up here with the two of you. And I couldn't be happier for the two of you, and I'm so excited for you to be joining the family, Kathleen. So I'll wrap up, and lastly, as a couple people mentioned, you know, as many of you know, we lost my Uncle Rick, John's dad, a few years ago. My Uncle Rick was a great man, one hell of a father, and what I saw from you, cuz, was incredible. The way you stepped up to help your mom, your sisters, the rest of our family, your now wife, and her family was some real grown-ass man children. That was awesome. And on this day, with your new beautiful wife, I know he would be incredibly happy and proud of you and the man that you've become, as I am. So with that, let's raise a glass to my cousin Jonathan.
Johnny!
Congratulations!
Let's go!
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be having another toast by Emma, Angelica, and Mary Rose.
But then we changed our minds and decided to make this all about us because, I mean, that's what sisters are for, right? So instead, we're gonna sit here and tell you guys all of the reasons that we think that their marriage is absolutely perfect for us. Number one, my sister Kathleen is finally nice to me all of the time. Thank you, Jonathan! tea. Kathleen is gonna host a nice ass family dinner where I can eat and drink for free. Huge perk to that relationship. Number three, I can always count on Jonathan to make an inappropriate comment at the dinner table to distract from whatever stupid, unfiltered comment I made a couple minutes before. Thank you, Jonathan. You really steal the show. Number four, we gained a handyman out of this relationship. We can always count on him for some manual labor. Just ask Grandma. He just completed her 2022 chore list of the year.
Somebody's got us for the light bulbs in.
Number five. When Jonathan and Kathleen moved in together, they bought a house. It was only right around the corner. It had a pool in the backyard. They said, you know, as family, any of you guys are welcome anytime you want. They didn't even make me offer my services as a pool girl. So thank you. Number six. As a family of five girls and only one single boy, we were hashtag blessed to gain not only another brother, but a brother who responded, reacted, and acknowledged all of our messages in the family group chat. So thank you.
Oh, that's a hard kiss, yeah.
We love you, Sean. All jokes aside, we truly are so happy for both of you for finding one another. You truly are the perfect combination of fire and ice. For example, you have Jonathan, who probably would not notice that I stole his car out of the driveway. And then you have my sister, Kathleen, who would yell at me for putting the TV remote down on the wrong couch cushion. It's all about the balance, baby. Jonathan, I truly never thought, while we were boon cruising through Yardville as high schoolers, that you would end up addition to this group of crazy people that make up our family. Kathleen, we truly could not be happier that you found your perfect match. Jonathan truly brings out the best in you, and we are so thankful to be included in your life together. We are so excited for what the future holds and all the memories you are to make in the years to come.
Woo! I'll put you on that one.
They say you don't marry the person that you can live with, but rather the person that you cannot live without. Everyone grab your drinks and please raise a glass to Kathleen and Jonathan, and let's cheers to a lifetime of happiness and love. Congratulations to Kathleen and Jonathan.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for our bride and our groom. Ladies and gentlemen, the dance floor is now open. I want to invite everyone to please join us in the center of the dance floor.
Oh my God, oh my God, this feeling's just begun. I'm saying things I've never said, doing things I've never done. Oh my God, when I see you, I should have run. But I'm frozen in motion and my head tells me to stop. Tells me to stop. Feelings I feel about us. Try to fight it but it's never enough. My heart is hurting, it's more than a crush. Cause I'm frozen in motion and my head tells me to stop. But my heart goes bum 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 bum. Cause my heart goes bum bum bum. Singing songs I've never sung. Oh my God, when I see you I should run. But I'm frozen in motion and my head tells me to stop. Tells me to stop. Feelings I feel about us. Try to fight it but it's never enough. My heart is hurting, it's more than a crush.
Cause I'm frozen in motion and my head tells me to stop, but my heart goes bum, 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 bum. Cause my heart goes bum, bum, bum.
My blues away. I'm gonna light up.
One more time, put your hands together for Brad and Green.